Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today, we're going to be taking a deep dive into our Bravo 2X diesel outdrive. Went to do just a standard fluid change for the season, and it did not look good. Any lube that turns that dark tells me that it's got some overheating issues going on. Now, what's causing the problem? I'm not quite sure. But we are going to start with the top end because the bottom end, it was just rebuilt last year, so it should be good to go. My theory at this point is probably going to be the clutch inside. So let's get that input shaft pulled out and take a peek. So if you're ready, we'll dive into this project. Can't wait to see what the inside of this looks like. And yes, there is no other way to open this up except for having this special tool. So just, if you're gonna do this, go ahead and get it. I don't see a lot of corrosion around it, so it shouldn't be a big deal. There she goes. Now the way this one sounded, I would have sworn it was my U-joints, because when you would turn it at a low RPM, you hear a lot of chatter going on. And I think that chatter that I'm hearing was the clutch on the inside engaging and disengaging rapidly when it was under stress. But there's no way to see that from the outside, so we're gonna open her up. All right. Be careful when you're pulling this out. You've got your shim that's right there. So she came out in one piece. That does not smell healthy. The bearings feel okay. Not too much wear on the gear. This one's got right at 800 hours on it total. So let's set this to the side. Still feels, the bearings feel good. At least the ones I can get my hands on. So I'm still betting on the clutch at this point. All right, next, we're going to go ahead and take off our top plate as well as our back. Take a peek inside. When you're doing this pried up very carefully, I was not putting a lot of pressure on that. Nothing alarming yet, although there was water intrusion into here. This was just one goopy mess. I'm pretty sure we're going to need to pull the linkage all the way apart and get that cleaned out. Evidently, that little seal right there failed and let water get into it, unfortunately. All right, let's go ahead and get our back cap off. If I remember correctly, those are 12.38, which I have. All right. Yeah, that was looking a little muddy in there. That's all right. We're going to make it better. All right, next, we need to get our shift shaft out of there. We've got a couple of Torx we need to release, then we can pull the shaft up. That's going to be a T30. Be glad you can't smell this. Now, of course, they make a tool to screw into the shaft and pull out. But we're going to find just a bolt that we can put in there and pop her out. All right, next, we need to reach down in there after we push the gear down against the spring and get out those two retainers. First, we're gonna see if we can get some of the oil out of the way so I can see what I'm doing. All right, back down. One and two. Let's take a look at our clutch. Along with its garter springs. Well, all right, guys, I don't think we need to break it apart any further. I feel quite confident that noise I was hearing was this clutch. I've seen a lot worse, but it is worn, looking really shiny. So I went and ordered up another one, and you can tell pretty much immediately what a new one's supposed to look like. So we're gonna go in and clean all of this up, install this new clutch along with its garter springs. Strange little device, isn't it? And that should take care of our issue. All right, guys, after multiple cans of cleaning spray and a few billion brain cells, I think we're finally ready to put this back together. I did have to sand back and then respray some of the casing, as brake cleaner has a tendency to eat paint, even as good a paint as the MerCruiser Phantom Black is. It can't put up with that. But I've got it cleaned up, everything's cleaned out. I believe we've got it ready to go back together. So let's reverse engines, no pun intended, and get this thing ready to go back on the boat. All right, we are not replacing the gears, but we are replacing the clutch and the garter springs associated with it. Go ahead and open up one of your gear lube bottles, because all of this stuff needs to be, or a lot of this stuff needs to be pre-lubed as it goes back together. I mean, it's all going to be immersed in it, but on first startup, we don't want to start it up dry, especially this brand new clutch. I wonder who came up with this design. Hey, let's put a spring inside and let it push against it. Okay. Make sure you haven't lost any of your thrust washers. Now, of course, they want you to use a stand while you're doing this, which I don't have, but hopefully we can balance it well enough to get this new retainer in there. There's one. I think that got it. Easy stuff. So you just want to look at our lower needle bearing and our thrust washer down at the bottom. I want to wipe these off real quick. Note the orientation. Don't flip it around. You should be able to see the marks from the needle bearing on that side, which you can. So let's go ahead and get it back in place. Now we can bring our clutch assembly in place. Be very careful letting this down, because we don't want to damage our bearing getting it to line up. There we go. All right. I'm happy-ish. Now we've got our second needle bearing and outer thrust washer. The marks from the needle bearing are facing back where they started. All right, I did clean up our shift arm, but I was none too happy with the way it turned out, especially that outer clamp that used to be replaceable, but evidently you have to buy the whole assembly, so that's what I went ahead and did, because last thing I want is a rusted piece like that just to snap loose, and then that'll just stop you in the water. We're going to go ahead and goop this down with some 2,4-C and then get it finagled in there. You have to rotate it like 90 degrees, because that's the way it's going to end up, right there. That should be it. Now, our shift cam. I did order another one, and I've looked at them. What I'm feeling just right here where that ramp is. Now, if that doesn't ramp it up far enough, it's going to prematurely wear the clutch, and that's the thing we just replaced, so I don't want to do it again. So we're going to go ahead and pop in the new one. We want these facing down. Here we go. Go and put a little Loctite on our bolts and get them started. All right, the real trick there is we needed to get the clutch in the right position, upper or lower, to where it would let the shift arm come all the way up and all the way out to where it'll be able to grab the shift cable when I go to reinstall it, because otherwise we were fighting against the garter spring. So we need to bring it up in the up position to where that bottom spring was pushing up on it and the top one was completely around it, so to speak. So it shifted into that quote gear. And we did get a new cap for this. Anything you see me putting together is going to have new seals on it. So any of these openings that has a seal, a new one's going in. There's no way I would reuse any of the old seals while putting this back together. I mean, just no. Even if they'd only been in there 6 months, wouldn't matter. I'd still replace them. Now that everybody's back together, we're going to go ahead and pre-lube some of this stuff even further and set her in place. There she goes. Let's get ready for our back cover, get our new seal in. All right, you hold together. All right, guys, we're almost finished up with this. Just gonna spin it around, install that input shaft, and then I'll spend a little bit of time kicking back some of this bad paint, priming it, and then repainting it, so at least it can make it through another season. Pretty much what I have to do every year, along with everybody else. Let's go ahead and bring it around. Now, the only thing I have left to do on the input shaft is just replace that O-ring, put my shim back in, and then we're good to go. And yes, I will be replacing these seals later. And here comes the fun part. Need to take this to 200 foot pounds, but we're extending it out by X amount. They have a chart where you measure your torque wrench and then degrade the amount of torque that you have to set because of that distance. So remember, yours is going to be different, but I will put that chart up so where you've got access to it, because you're probably not going to have the same torque wrench as I have. So basically measuring from the center point of our attachment for the socket to the midpoint of the handle, about right here. This one's looking like 22 inches. And if we go look at our little handy dandy chart, 129 foot pounds. So that's what we're gonna set our wrench to. Just make sure that's straight. That should be it. Well, all right, guys, that's pretty much gonna wrap up this video. All I have to do now is fill it up with gear lube, maybe do a little bit more cleaning and painting, put some new seals on the outside or O-rings on the outside, as well as some decals, and then I'll be ready to head back down to the coast and get it reinstalled. Well, listen, if you need these or any other parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments about this video? Leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.